Welcome back, Wildcats. We're excited to have you back and can't wait to tell you all the news after the joyful tech break. Before starting, we have a surprise for all you listeners. A new member. This is someone who we actually had interviewed before. It is Anastasia.
I guess us podders really charmed her into joining us. Anastasia, thank you for joining us. Please introduce yourself to the listeners.
Hi, I'm Anastasia. I'm in year 11 and I'm excited to be here.
We all just came back from our 2 weeks long TED break. It was a blast for me. How were everyone else holiday? Well, starting off, I went to the beach. I also dyed my hair, which took me actually 2 days to cancel the purple out, but it was really worth it. Anastasia, how was yours?
It was amazing. I went to Thailand, first Bangkok and then Krabi for a little bit, and I saw two stadium gigs, so that was awesome. Izzy?
Me and Ben also went to Bangkok, but we went separately from Anastasia, and it was really fun. We watched Ed Sheeran in a live stadium, and we also went to a Columbia Pictures water park.
And we went to a dog cafe.
In my holiday, it was a surprise. My mum had us wake up at 5 a.m. because it was my sister's birthday. We went to Thailand and then went there for a bit. But for some reason on the way to where we were going, my mum, instead of putting the stadium that we were supposed to go to, put some Muay Thai stadium. And we had to wait like an extra 2 hours to get to the stadium where we watched Coldplay, which was really, really good. I don't know if it was better than Ed Sheeran because I watched both, but the best part of my holiday had to have been going to Maldives as a surprise, which is probably the best place I've ever been, apart from my home.
Yeah. I just went to Haiphong, which is near the ocean, and just relaxing there with my mom and, I don't know, something study. My GCSE.
Sounds just about right. Pebble?
I actually went to my hometown, which is in the middle of Vietnam.
Oh,
yeah,
where is
really
it?
Far. It's in Nghệ An.
Oh, wait, we have the same hometown.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, no, nice. Anyway, I went there to visit my grandparents, which I do annually, and then just watch some fireworks and overall just relaxing.
Lastly, Mr. James, what did you do?
Before I talk about me, I want to ask a few questions first, and then I'll share what I did over the holiday. So my question's actually for people who stayed in Vietnam during the Tet holiday. So I want to know specifically what you did, where you went. A lot of people, I think people you just mentioned, you went to your hometown. I'm very interested in some of the traditions, some of the things you might have done for the Tet celebration. What would we expect to see going to somebody's hometown for a Tet holiday? Can you tell us a bit more about that?
Firstly, one thing that will be easily noticeable, it's actually spring blossom. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's everyone's must have in Vietnam. And also, if you are, a special person, you can actually get lucky money from people. Yeah?
Yeah. Pebble, how much lucky money? Not how much. Do you get lucky money?
I did. Oh. Okay. This is my last year, so they have to treat me well. And one thing, if you go to the rurals, I say the rurals countryside, but some of the people in city will do this, but you can actually watch people who make bánh tét, and they will put it in a huge pot and just stay awake overnight to cook it.
Yeah.
And while you're at it, it has to be cooked with firewood, not like electricity. So you can have some grilled chicken, grilled corn, grilled potatoes, those kind of things. It's a very enjoyable experience.
Yeah, it's very Vietnamese. I didn't go back to my hometown. I was just in Hanoi. But I think another tradition is that on the 30th, on the last day of the Lunar New Year calendar, there's this show that Vietnamese people often watch,
right? Oh yeah,
right?
Tao Quân. Yeah, it's called Tao Quân. It's a show where they do some comedies about Vietnamese problems and achievements.
Yeah, and they acted as goddesses.
Yeah, goddesses.
God and goddesses.
God and goddesses, yeah.
Yeah, like the traditional Vietnamese, higher spiritual figures talking about the last year issues and everything. Yeah, it's really fun. It's really fun to watch. Yeah.
Nice. Thanks for sharing. And there was something I spoke to a friend of mine recently, and they explained to me that on very specific days, you're supposed to go to different parts or visit or host different parts of the family. So you go to your mum's dad's side of the family, or can you explain that? Am I explaining it correctly?
I think it really depends on the people. Mm. As long as you're in Tet, in my family at least, as long as you're in Tet, you can just go and visit all the relatives. It doesn't matter if it's parents, it's dad's side or mom's side, as long as you are visiting them.
Yeah, lucky money.
Yeah, that's basically the sole purpose why children go follow their parents, is to get lucky money.
Yeah.
And the parents are like, oh no, I have to give people
lucky money.
The
joy of Lunar New Year. Well, I guess that's it. I hope you guys, you listeners did well, fun things over the Tet break as well, and get a lot of lucky monies.
Also, on this Monday, the 19th of February, I'd like to also say happy birthday to my dad, as he's just turned 40, so happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Yeah.
Wait, that was such a sad happy birthday.
Yeah,
let's sing a song.
Yeah.
No.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Andrew. Happy birthday to you.
Before we move on, there's something we want to share with you.
DJ Hina, can we have a beat?
Okay.
Yo, it's Teeling and Hina. The hits are set it off. Joined by Harrison and Pebble, they never come soft. With Ben on the beat, Izzy bringing the flow, Anastasia on the mic, watch us steal the show.
Mr. James and Mick guiding us along. ISPH Global Podcast, where we all belong. From Teeling's inside to Pebble's laughter so bright. Harrison, handsomeness.
Potters of the cast with our crew in full swing. ISPH School Podcast making voices ring. With joy in our hearts and knowledge to share, we're spreading good vibes everywhere.
So here's to the great Mr. James and crew. ISPH School Podcast salute to you. With laughter and learning, we're paving the way. Potter of the cast, let's seize the day! Woo! Yeah!
Yeah, yeah.
It's Anastasia and me. So guys, how did we do? Are you guys impressed?
It was embarrassing.
What?
Oh. It was really good.
Thank you.
Compared to how much time you had limited to your reasoning, it was really good.
Well, surprise, we didn't do it. It was AI generated.
Wow, I really couldn't tell. It was so flawless.
That's just our flawless rapping skills, not the AI.
Okay, well, maybe we shouldn't take the credit from AI. But AI's been developing really quickly and it's used frequently. But it's become kind of controversial. Not only whether or not it's ethical to use, but also whether it has enough creativity to outdo us humans. So we put it to the test by asking ChatGPT to write us a rap about the Potters of the cast.
Have any of you ISPH listeners walked past a poster from us at school? I'm sure our posters really impressed you guys. All the credit goes to our members Izzy and Hyuna. Thank you guys for your creativity. And here's a secret. There's a limited edition version of the poster. And it's your mission to find it. And if you find one, there's an award written on the poster, so try and find it. Good luck.
That's it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed our 8th episode, and good luck finding the posters.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Amazing.
You got a friend in me.